Everyone, how are you all? I am sure you are fit and fiddle with your family. Students, today I teach you a new poem, that is Trees Blessings, Tree Blessings, which is written by Ruskin Bond. Now let us know about Ruskin Bond. So he is a Ruskin Bond. Ruskin Bond, born in 1934. He is an Indian author of British descent. So descent means, so derivation from an ancestors, means his grandfather and mother were from British country. Okay. So most of his writings show a very strong influence of the social life in the hill stations at the foothills of the Himalayas. His writings are replete with humor. Okay, replete means filled. So his writing, most of the his writings are filled with humor, wisdom and wit. So his stories manifest a great love for nature and people. So he has received the Sahitya Academy Award for English writing in India for Our Trees Still Grow in Dehra. So he has also been conferred with the Padma Shri Award, which is the fourth highest civilian award in our country. Okay. Now let me switch on the next slide. Let me read the poem and explain, student. Now we all know trees are a blessing in disguise for human beings. Read and find out how the poet planted the tree and considered it as a blessing. Student, a disguise. Disguise means to give someone or oneself a different appearance in order to conceal one's identity. Okay. Ruskin Bond, in this poem, shares the thought of his grandmother, who was the opinion that the house that has tree around is blessed. Let us start the poem, Tree Blessing. Grandmother often said, "Blessed is the house upon whose walls the shade of an old tree softly falls. We had no tree near our cottage, so I planted one last spring. It's 6 months old now and growing fast. In 6 years' time, there will be a blessing." Written by Ruskin Bond. So, grandmother often said, "Blessed is the house upon whose walls the shade of an old tree softly falls." So what grandmother says? That she said many times. So often means many times. So she said many times that blessed is the house or the cottage or the home where the tree is there. Where the tree is there. Okay. The shade, we had no tree near our cottage. See, now grandmother is saying that they had no tree near their cottage. See. So, I planted one last spring. So, I means the poet. Okay. The poet is saying that he planted a tree near his cottage. He planted a tree near his cottage. So, when? During spring. So, here he has mentioned here, I planted one last spring. So when he planted during spring. So spring means is the season. Spring is the season after winter and before summer. This is spring season. Okay. It's 6 months old now. So now how many months have gone? That it's 6 months old now. Who? The tree. Okay, next, and growing fast. So the tree is growing The tree is the growing fast day by day, day by day. Okay. In 6 years time, there will be a blessing. So after 6 years, that small plant which the poet had planted, it will become what? It will become a blessing. Why? Why? Because it will give shade. Tree gives many other things, as already you learnt in the first chapter, the lesson, the giving tree. So in that, what you learnt? The tree gives shade, food, fruits, vegetables, okay, for shelter. So it helps the birds to build their nests. Correct, no? So you all will plant a tree and will protect it. So children, you all, what you have to do? You all will plant a tree and will protect it. Okay. I hope you have enjoyed the poem and we'll meet in the next class. Okay. Thank you.